Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss about the histology of peripheral nervous system. So all the nervous tissue other than the brain and the spinal cord, it is called as the peripheral nervous system. So this consists of nerves. The peripheral nervous system consists of nerves, which are nothing but the bundles of nerve fibers. So here in this image, if you see, this is a bundle of nerve fiber. All these small darkened areas what you are seeing are nothing but the nerves, and this complete thing is a bundle, and this is another bundle, this is another. So bundles of nerve fibers together, they form a peripheral nerve. And the other thing that is there within the peripheral nervous system are the ganglia, right? So there is a dorsal root ganglion of the spinal nerve, which is also called as spinal ganglion, and the other one is the autonomic ganglion, which is present within the sympathetic chain. So sympathetic ganglion we say. So this is nothing but the collection. A ganglia is nothing but a collection of neurons and nerve fibers which are present outside the CNS. CNS is central nervous system, that consists of brain and spinal cord. So the collection of neurons within the brain and spinal cord, they are called as nuclei, whereas in peripheral nervous system they are called as ganglion, right? So a nerve, it is defined as a collection of nerve fibers. Nerve is nothing but a collection of nerve fibers, and the nerve fibers may be myelinated or unmyelinated, and all these nerve fibers, they are held together by a connective tissue, right? And this consists of nerve fibers and neuroglial cells. So the neuroglial cells which are present here are the Schwann cells, and these Schwann cells actually they surround the nerve fiber, and this Schwann cell will form a myelin sheath around each nerve fiber. This is one nerve fiber. So surrounding this nerve fibers, there will be myelin sheath. So here if you see, this is the myelin sheath which is shown in this image. So this myelin sheath is laid down by the Schwann cell, right? And what are these nerve fibers? The nerve fibers are nothing but the axons and dendrites, can be anything, but usually axons will be there in the nerves. So any process of the neuron, cell process of the neuron, be it an axon or dendrite, they are called as the nerve fibers, right? So the nerve fiber is first surrounded by a Schwann cell, and that Schwann cell, if it is a myelinated nerve, it will form the myelin sheath. If it is an unmyelinated nerve, you will not see the myelin sheath. So nerve fiber, first it is covered by myelin sheath, which is laid down by the Schwann cell, and then it is covered by a thin layer of endoneurium. So what is this endoneurium? This endoneurium is a connective tissue made up of delicate collagen fibers. And also you will see those collagen fibers are formed by the fibroblast cells. So within the endoneurium, if you see on higher magnification, you will see very delicate collagen fibers as well as the fibroblast nuclei. But at light microscopy level, the endoneurium shows the nuclei of fibroblasts, and you actually can't distinguish them from the nerve fibers separately on low magnification. Then these are all the nerve fibers, and each nerve fiber is surrounded by myelin sheath in the first, which is laid down by Schwann cell, and then it is surrounded by the endoneurium. right? And this group of nerve fibers, now they have formed a bundle, and this bundle of nerve fibers, now it is covered by a perineurium. So this is called as a perineurium. Okay, so the perineurium, what is this perineurium? So this perineurium, it is a sheath made up of around 3 to 4 layers of squamous cells. Squamous cells are nothing but flat cells. So here you can see flat cells, nuclei of the flat cells. So this 3 to 4 layers of these flat cells you will see in the perineurium, and also some extracellular material. And these cells, they show basal lamina and are contractile in nature. So this squamous cells, they are contractile in nature, and this is also a semi-permeable membrane. This perineurium is a semi-permeable membrane. So why do we need semi-permeability here? So they actually they are more like epitheloid tissue. When you compare with the epineurium and endoneurium, perineurium it resembles like an epitheloid tissue, right? So that is perineurium. And this is one bundle of nerve fibers, this is another bundle of nerve fibers, this is another bundle. So many bundles together, they are covered by the epineurium. So this outermost layer what you are seeing is the epineurium. Okay, and this is a dense connective tissue. This epineurium is a dense connective tissue. It also goes inside between the bundles. So this in between the bundles also you are seeing this part. This is also a part of epineurium. So that means it not only covers on the external aspect, the epineurium also goes in between the bundles. Okay, and why do you think that is going in between the bundles? It will actually bind all these bundles together. To bind the bundles together, the epineurium goes in between the bundles. And also, it contains blood vessels. So, this is a blood vessel here. What you are seeing is a blood vessel. And blood vessels are seen here in the epineurium. So this is the endoneurium here, okay, surrounding each nerve fiber, and then this is the perineurium surrounding each bundle, and many bundles together, they are surrounded by the epineurium. This is an epineurium, and epineurium, it is a dense connective tissue and it consists of blood vessels. So these are the blood vessels which are present in the epineurium. Right. So that was the histology of a nerve fiber. Now coming to the ganglia. I told you that we are going to discuss about two ganglions. One is dorsal root ganglion, which is nothing but a spinal ganglion, and the other one is an autonomic ganglion or a sympathetic ganglion. So now in this image, if we see, this is the section of the spinal cord. This is the spinal cord here, and from the spinal cord, these are the rootlets of the spinal nerve. Okay, so this is the spinal nerve actually. So, spinal nerve origin, if we see, it has got ventral rootlets and dorsal rootlets. Okay, there will be many rootlets here, ventral and dorsal, and these rootlets join together to form the dorsal root and a ventral root. Okay, and this dorsal root has got a ganglion. So this bulge what you are seeing here is a dorsal root ganglion or the spinal ganglion, also called as sensory ganglion, because most of the sensory fibers from the body, they reach this level and then they enter into the spinal cord. So this is the dorsal root ganglion here. This is the ventral root, and both these dorsal and ventral roots join together to form the spinal nerve here. Okay, and then the spinal nerve will again divide into a dorsal ramus and a ventral ramus. Okay, so now we are going to see the histology of this sensory ganglion or spinal ganglion or dorsal root ganglion, all one and the same. Okay, so this is also known as sensory ganglion. So it is a collection of sensory neurons on the dorsal root of the spinal nerve. I hope you understood, this is the dorsal root of the spinal nerve, right? And now each ganglion, it is surrounded by a connective tissue capsule. Now this complete bulge what you are seeing on the external aspect, it is covered by a connective tissue capsule, which is nothing but the epineurium of the dorsal root. Now this dorsal root is nothing but a nerve, right? So the nerve on its external aspect, it is covered by epineurium. Now that epineurium here near the ganglion, it is termed as capsule for that ganglion. Okay, and beneath the capsule, the ganglion contains large cell bodies arranged in groups. So if you see here, these are all the cell bodies, these pink areas what you are seeing here, these are all the cell bodies. Okay, and cell bodies, they are arranged in groups. Okay, this is one group. Okay, and here you are seeing some nerve fibers, then this is another group here. This is one group, this is another group. Here you are seeing another group. Okay, so this is a group of nerve cells or neurons here. Okay, and in between the groups you will see the nerve fibers. So these are the nerve fibers which you will see in between the groups. And if you observe, this is a cell body, this is a cell body, and this is a cell body. All these are the cell bodies or the neurons. And in between and around the groups of the neurons, there are bundles of nerve fibers. So these are all the bundles of nerve fibers which are seen. This is one group of neurons, this is another group, right? In between them, these are the nerve fibers. So that is the picture we will see in a sensory ganglion. And the point to be noted here is we will see myelinated nerve fibers here, and most of the nerve fiber bundles are seen in the central part of the ganglion. This is the central part of the ganglion. So here we are seeing many number of nerve fibers, whereas the cells, a group of cells will be seen in the peripheral part. Peripheral part is on the outer side, right? So in the central part of the ganglion, we are seeing the nerve fibers, and in the peripheral part, we are seeing the groups of neurons, right? Then the neurons of dorsal root ganglion, we'll see in the next slide. So here, this is the magnified image of the dorsal root ganglion. So each cell in this dorsal root ganglion, it is large first of all, and spherical, that is, it is spherical in 2D dimension, we can say it is a circular, and with large pale staining nuclei. So here this is the nucleus here in the center, right? So this is pale staining, whereas the euchromatic nuclei here, this is, and dark staining nucleolus. So this outline is for the nucleus, which is pale staining, but it shows a prominent nucleolus in the center. Okay, so this one, so what are the features of the neurons in the dorsal root ganglion? They are large cells, they are spherical, and the nucleus is pale staining with a prominent nucleolus, and Now each cell has got many satellite cells. So these cells what you are seeing here, these are called as the satellite cell. This is one, this is the other one, right? So each cell has got many satellite cells. This point you have to remember, because the autonomic ganglia will show less number of satellite cells in its neurons. Okay, so the neurons of dorsal root ganglion, large spherical bodies, pale staining euchromatic nucleus with the prominent nucleolus, and each neuron is completely surrounded by the satellite cells, and these satellite cells which form the sheath, these satellite cells are forming a sheath around each neuron, right? Are much smaller. If you see, this is the large cell, and compared to this neuron, these satellite cells are very small, but they completely cover the neuron. Okay, and how will you describe each satellite cell? Each satellite cell is flat or low cuboidal in nature, and it forms an inner capsule around each neuron. So satellite cell is forming a many satellite cells are together, they forming inner sheath around each neuron. And the fibroblast and fibers form outer capsule surrounding the inner capsule, right? So on the exterior, now if you see just outside here it is all the fibroblast and the collagen fibers are there, whereas this inner sheath is formed by the satellite cells. Okay, and what is the main purpose of these satellite cells? They prevent unwanted depolarization of sensory neurons. So unwanted depolarization is prevented by these satellite cells. Okay, right. So this is about the dorsal root ganglion. Now coming to the sympathetic trunk ganglion, also called as autonomic ganglion. So here if you see, this is a sympathetic chain. Okay, and this bulge what you are seeing here is nothing but the sympathetic trunk ganglion. Okay, this one, sympathetic trunk ganglion, this is how it is, sympathetic trunk, which is a part of autonomic nervous system. So it is the ganglion of autonomic nervous system and lies along the sympathetic trunk, and they contain cell bodies of postsynaptic motor neurons of autonomic nervous system. So now we are going to see the histology of autonomic ganglion. So what is this? They contain, this is also covered by thin capsule of connective tissue and consists of small irregular neurons dispersed between the nerve fibers. Now, how was the sensory ganglion? The cell was large, but here it is small. So this difference you have to understand, and it is not spherical, it is irregular. Why is it irregular? The shape, you can see that it is not rounded, it is irregular. This is one cell here. The shape is irregular because it is multipolar neuron. Okay, so that's why the shape of the cell is irregular. Whereas in the sensory ganglion, it was spherical. And there a group of neurons were present, but here the cells are dispersed in between the nerve fibers. So this is a nerve fiber here. See, all nerve fibers are there, and in between the nerve fibers, dispersed in between them, we are seeing the multipolar neurons. Okay, so this is the cell here. Okay, this is another cell here. And one more important thing is, there we have seen the nucleus is centrally placed, pale staining, and prominent nucleolus. But here the nucleus is eccentrically placed, that means in the cell towards its periphery we will see the nucleus here. So this is the eccentrically placed nucleus. Here also we are going to see prominent nucleoli, but eccentrically placed nucleus. And the cytoplasm has Nissl's bodies. So these yellow things what you are seeing are nothing but the Nissl's bodies, which are nothing but the lipofuscin granules. Okay, so this is one more feature. And the point that I have already told, the satellite cells are less here compared to the spinal ganglion. Okay, the satellite cells are less. So in between the nerve cells there is a supportive connective tissue, blood vessels you will see here. This is the blood vessel here, and bundles of nerve fibers, both myelinated preganglionic and unmyelinated postganglionic. So in between the cells we will see myelinated and unmyelinated nerve fibers. And the cells are not seen in groups, they are dispersed in between the nerve fibers, and the size is small, irregular, and the nucleus is eccentrically placed. Whereas in sensory ganglion, the cell shape is large, I mean size is large, shape is spherical, centrally placed pale staining nucleus with prominent nucleoli and more number of satellite cells, right? So this is the sympathetic ganglion. Now in this image we'll just see the comparison. Autonomic ganglia, the cell size is small, irregular, right, and eccentrically placed nucleus with prominent nucleolus. This central dot what you are seeing is the nucleolus. This is the nucleus and this one is the nucleolus where I have placed the pointer. Right, and because it is multipolar neuron, it is irregular in shape, okay, and dispersed in between the nerve fibers. These are the nerve fibers, both myelinated and unmyelinated nerve fibers we are going to see in between the cells. So this is the autonomic ganglion, and the satellite cells are very less in number when you compare with the sensory ganglion. This is a satellite cell, okay. So here you can see small cells dispersed in between the nerve fibers. And here if we see dorsal root ganglion, the image itself shows this is the spherical large cell, right, pale staining nucleus and prominent nucleolus, and the nerve fibers are present towards the center and the cells are present towards the periphery. And each cell, if you observe, there are many satellite cells. Okay, so these points you have to remember. So what have we learnt in this lecture? The histology of the nerve fiber, nerve as such, then two ganglia we have seen, sensory ganglion and autonomic ganglion. In the nerve, what we have seen, bundles of nerve fibers, they are covered by myelin sheath first, which is laid down by the Schwann cell, and then endoneurium is covering it. Then all the nerve fibers, when they form a bundle, that bundle is covered by a perineurium, which is semi-permeable, and then all bundles of nerve fibers together, they are ensheathed by the epineurium, which is a dense connective tissue. It binds the bundles together, and there are blood vessels which are present within the epineurium, right? So that is about the nerve fiber. Then two ganglia we have seen in this image comparatively, right? Thank you.